Good morning, folks. We're here at the global headquarters of Infinitum Electric, and I thought I'd do a quick video. It's a common question that we get here at company, which is, what is a VFD and why do I need one? So let me get settled in and I'll do a quick explanation. We're here in the Infinitum Electric Sales and Marketing Center of Excellence in Round Rock, Texas. And we had a question around, what is variable frequency drive? How does it work? Where do I use it? And so the goal of this video is to explain that. All right, so let's start with how a motor operates without a VFD. Well, you have the incoming power in most industrial and commercial facilities. It's a 480 volt AC at 60 hertz. And this voltage changes depending on where you are geographically, and this frequency also varies around the world. But for this example, we use that. And then you have three phase power coming in, going into a motor. And because you have a fixed voltage and a fixed frequency, the performance of that motor is essentially fixed. So if you ever want to change the speed of the motor or change the torque, you need a VFD. And so this AC, 480 volt AC, is a sinusoidal power input. And you have three phases, so you have, each one is shifted 120 degrees. I'm not an artist here, but hopefully that explains it. And so now let's touch on how do we vary that frequency and voltage. The frequency, by the way, is 60 cycles. So this from here to here, that's one cycle, 60 cycles per second. And the voltage is this 480 volt here. All right, so let me just draw out what a VFD looks like, and I'll be back in a second to explain the different components. This is the topology of a VFD, a drive. And we have the rectifier, which is this piece right here. We have the DC bus, and then we have the inverter. Sometimes you'll hear people call a VFD an inverter, and that's a misnomer, because a VFD is a component within a inverter is a component within a VFD, but they're not interchangeable in terminology. So a rectifier essentially takes in that 480 volt AC signal and turns it into a DC signal. The DC bus smooths that out a little bit, and then the inverter is what chops that up. And the reason why we do that is we can essentially change the frequency and the voltage to control the speed and torque of that motor. So by chopping this up, we can essentially create a voltage that looks very similar to a AC signal. And so the length of how long we leave it on, the time that we leave it on, impacts how high this voltage is. So let's say this peak might be 678 here. If we leave it on, this RMS of this voltage will be closer to that peak. In contrast, for example, if we were to turn it off for a longer period of time and do something like this, your RMS here is going to be a lot shallower, a lot lower. The other thing that we can do is change the frequency. So how fast we turn this on and off and how many cycles we have in this waveform essentially affects the speed of the motor. So for example, most motors operate at the rate of speed at 60 hertz, at least in the US. And if we were to change that speed down to, let's say, 45 hertz, it would proportionally reduce the speed of that operating motor. And so that's why we use a VFD. And then by changing the voltage, we're able to adjust the torque going into the motor. There's a lot more to it than that, but at a higher level, that's a brief explanation. Now, in this particular image out here, I show some switches. So these switches right here, And this is what turns on and off to allow for this. And so this waveform, for example, is representative of what occurs on each one of the phase. So times this by 3, and that's what you would see there. And the way this works is you have power coming in. You'd, for example, have this one turning on, power going through here. And let's say in this particular example, you might have this one turning on. So power comes out through here. And then the other option would be like, maybe you turn this one on and it power goes out and this one turns on. And so at any given time, one top one and one bottom one is turned on, and that allows for that transfer of the power, for the energy. These switches here, for example, typically in industrial commercial VFDs are IGBTs. It's insulated gate bipolar transistor, IGBT. IGBTs typically switch at 4 to 16 kilohertz. That's what you typically find in most industrial VFDs. We have prototypes that we've tested our motor with, and we switched up to 80 kilohertz. More recently, however, we've utilized silicon carbide MOSFETs, and that switch at around 200 kilohertz. Generally speaking, our motor prefers a high switching frequency, and we'll talk about this general topic in a later video. But in a nutshell, what is a VFD? It enables you to take an AC signal, transform that into something that you can control. So you can control the frequency and you can control the voltage. And essentially it looks like an AC signal coming into the drive. This by the way, is a little choppy. So the actual curve is not as smooth, but the intent is that the motor sees it as a sinusoidal wave. And that is a VFD. Thank you.